Welcome. In this video, you'll learn how to make an inventory system where you can drag and drop items in a slot. You can also move the items from an inventory to a hotbar. If you are looking to create an inventory you can reuse in your Godot project, then this is the tutorial for you. If you want to follow along, there is a link to the project file in the description. Once you've opened the project file, three scenes have been included: the main scene, the inventory scene, and the slot container scene. In the slot container scene, add a script, and at the top of the script, add a class name. We'll call it slot. Let's begin by working on the drag and drop for the slot container. To implement the drag and drop, we'll make use of three methods provided by the control node. The first being getDragData, canDropData, and finally dropData method. Godot uses the getDragData method to get data for dragging and dropping onto controls that need it. Each slot can hold an item, and those items contain data like its texture, the item quantity, etc. It all depends on what you want for your game. However, for our example, we'll simply make use of an item texture and quantity. To create the item which holds the data, will make use of resources. And if I do create a tutorial on resources in Godot in the future, I'll be sure to leave a link in the description. Now back to our code, create a new script, and this should extend from resources, and add a class name item, and we are going to add two export variables, one for the texture, which I've set to new, and quantity, and I assign 0 as its argument. Now save that. Back to the slot container script, add an export variable slot item resource. Set its type as item and assign null as its argument. In the getDragData function, we'll validate if there's an item in the slot item resource. If there isn't, we'll return out of the function, because the slot probably is empty and there is nothing to drag. Now we want to set our drag preview, which is displayed when dragging an item. Add a variable preview texture and assign a new texture rect. Then we'll set the preview texture to the slot texture rect texture. Then set its expand mode to 1, which is ignore size. Then for size, simply use what works best for you. Lastly, add a new variable preview and assign a new control as its value. Then add the preview texture as a child of the preview node. We'll call a method setDragPreview and pass preview as an argument. Finally, getDragData requires a return value to store as its data. We can return the slot item resource. However, when we implementing the logic for swapping, we'll require the slot container. So instead, we'll return the slot container. Here is an example. Once we drag an item, you can see the item preview. However, we can't drop the item in any of the empty slots. So let's fix that. Back to the script, we'll make use of the canDropData function to test if the data parameter can be dropped. So we'll check if data is slot and return its value. Now, whenever we drag an item on an empty slot, we can drop the item. However, now we need to move and display the item in the new slot, which is what the dropData function is for. We'll say slot item resource is equal to new, meaning if an empty slot, then we'll call a method setItem and pass the data slot item resource. In the setItem function, we assigned item resource to the slot item resource variable, then assigned a new texture and set the label text to the item quantity. Now we need to empty the previous slot, so we call a method setDataEmpty in the data parameter. In this function, we will simply set both the texture and slot item resource to new and empty the label. With that, you can also move items from one slot to the other. However, we also want our inventory to swap two items, so let's implement that. Now, slot item resource equals to new will return true if the slot is empty, else, meaning we don't have an item in the slot, we'll store the slot item resource in a temporary variable, then call the set item method and pass the data slot item resource as an argument. And for the data, call its set item as well and pass the temporary variable as an argument. That wraps it up for slot container. Finally is the inventory, which I will explain as quick as possible. Once you have your inventory UI layout, add a script to the inventory node, declare an onReady variable of the grid container and an export variable which holds an array of items in the inventory. Then I've added a function to add items to the inventory. This method simply loops through all the slots in the grid container, then check if that slot is empty. If this is true, we create a new item and assign a texture and a random number as its quantity. Then call the slot set item method and return out of the function. Lastly is the clear all inventory item. Start by clearing the items array, then loop through all the slots in the grid container and call the set data empty method. In the main scene, connect the add item button press signal to the add item resource method and the clear items button press signals to the clear all inventory items method. Once you have done that, your inventory should be ready and you can add an item to the inventory and drag and drop as a new slot. We'll add a second item and we can swap these two items, then click to clear all item. If you made it here, thanks for watching, and if you are curious on how I made the gardening game from the start of the video, then simply click the video and I'll see you there.